My text coming tonight from 1 Kings chapter 3. 1 Kings chapter 3. We're going to read back over some of what Brother Coffey read for us. And thank Brother Coffey for that prayer. Truly, I believe y'all keep Brother Campbell in the prayer. Keep calling me by name.
Amen.
Call me by name because the struggles that I go through each day in life, but I'm going to keep pressing on like Apostle Paul said. Understand that scripture now. You got to strain. You got to put your faith groups on. You got to move on. Mm-hmm. No matter the difficulty and the thing that you experience in life. Because like Brother Coffey preached this morning, offense is going to come.
Yeah.
In Gibeon, the Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream by night. And God said, Ask what I shall give thee. And Solomon said, Thou hast showed unto thy servant David, my father, great mercy.
Yeah.
According as he walked before thee in truth and in righteousness and in uprightness of heart with thee, thou hast kept for him this great kindness that thou hast given him a son to sit on his throne as it is this day. And now, O Lord my God, thou hast made thy servant king indeed instead of David, my father. And I am but a little child. He ain't a child. He just in his spirit. Not a child, but Solomon already got a son and he married.
Right.
I know not how to go out or come in. And thy servant is in the midst of thy people, which thou hast chosen. A great people that cannot be numbered nor counted for multitude. Give therefore thou servant a understanding heart to judge thy people, that I may discern between good and bad. For who is able to judge this thou so great a people? From verse 9, I want to talk to you on a subject tonight. Give you wisdom. Give me wisdom. And as Solomon, David's son, has built the temple of God, which David's father was supposed to build. But God, in the midst of that, told David that you're not going to build it. You're a man of war. You got that blood of God. He said, but your son Solomon is going to build the temple.
Yeah.
He said, I'm going to take Solomon and build that temple.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to show the mercy that I showed to you. I'm going to show it to your son.
Mm-hmm.
And in the process of that, did you know that Solomon was the second child from Bathsheba?
Yes, he was. Yeah. Yeah.
The first child died, but Solomon was Bathsheba's baby.
Yeah, yeah.
And God took a baby from a Persian woman and made him in the line of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And Solomon, you see in the text that Solomon is a very wise man off the bat, because Solomon asked something to God, and God, as we go through the text, God was very pleased with what Solomon asked him. And I want to take from that text as we go along, I want to show us, sometime in our prayer, we need to ask God for what pleases him.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Because if we ask him for what pleases him, look what he'll do at the end.
Yes.
We need to ask God for wisdom, for understanding.
Yeah.
For kindness,
mm-hmm.
for the things that will make us better Christians,
that
we can go on forth and do God's will.
With the
I'm going to say it like Reverend Knight said, with the stuff God used, you can't use.
Yeah.
With the stuff God used, you can't lose.
Right.
Because if God is for you, who can be against you?
Amen. Amen.
Now, before we take off, I want to say this. Wisdom is a noun. Wisdom is the quality of having experience, knowledge, and good judgment.
Yeah.
And the quality of being wise.
Mm-hmm.
But wisdom is very unique in God, because God used it to develop the world.
Mm-hmm.
Before he brought it to prayer, he brought it, thought about it with wisdom. Well, Solomon was asking God for, give me a listening heart.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That I can, that when I hear something, that I can listen and think it out.
Yeah.
But not what he asked God for wasn't ordinary wisdom. Yeah. He asked him for divine wisdom.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Because the wisdom of the world, we know God turns it upside down.
Uh-huh.
But he asked him for the divine wisdom. And Solomon asked him for the wisdom that he had so great of people, the people that he was over. And y'all give me, y'all better be praying for me.
Come on.
You
all right?
And when he not only do a kingly wisdom, not only do a man of God need wisdom that run a congregation, but we all need wisdom.
Amen. Amen. Right.
We all need to work together to help him to make the congregation go to where God wanted to go.
Yes.
So we all got to have a listening heart towards each other.
Yes.
Right.
So wisdom plays both ways. Mm-hmm. It goes both ways. Mm-hmm. It just ain't for the man of God. It's for each and every one of us to have an understanding heart.
Yeah.
Amen.
And then when Solomon goes through get the wisdom that God gave him, he immediately had to use it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He immediately had to lose it.
Yeah.
And the thing that came at Solomon when he immediately had to use it was a very user situation.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
Brother Stops, you ready?
Yes, sir.
Let's get over here in verse 16.
Amen. Then came there two women, mm-hmm. they were harlots, under the king, and stood before him. And the one woman said, "O my Lord, and I and this woman dwell in one house, and I was delivered a child with her in the house. And it came to pass the third day after that I was delivered that this woman was delivered also, and we were together. There was no stranger with us in the house, save we two in the house. And this woman's child died in the night, because she overlaid it. And she arose at midnight and took my son from beside me, while thine handmaiden slept, and laid it in her bosom."
Sorry for a minute, first off. Now you see, not only he just didn't have to govern the church for him. These women hollered. Y'all know what a holler is.
Right, yeah.
They were prostitutes. This is a woman that slept in the night. She done laid or overlaid me. She done smothered the baby.
Right, yeah.
She done smothered the baby. She done killed her baby. And now she done caught this other sister sleep, and she done swapped baby.
Yeah.
She done swapped. This gonna be significant now, because if somebody discerns between something like that, boy, you got to have some divine wisdom. And then she rose at midnight and took my son from beside me while thine handmaid slept, and laid it in her bosom, and laid her dead child in my bosom. One thing about a mama know when her baby dead or not. You can swap that baby all you want to, but that woman gonna know. Woman said, "No, my baby ain't dead. I feel it with them." She know I took them babies. Mama took them babies for 9 months. The woman don't know. Wait a minute, best friend.
"And when I arose in the morning to give my child suck, behold, it was dead. But when I had considered it in the morning, behold, it was not my son, which I did bear." The other woman said, "Nay, but the living is my son, and the dead is thy son." And this said, "No, but the dead is thy son, and the living is my son."
Mm-hmm.
Thus they spake before the king. Then said the king, the one said, "This is my son that liveth, and thy son is dead." And the other said, "Nay, but thy son is the dead, and my son is the living."
Right.
And the king said, "Bring me a sword." And they brought him a sword before the king. And the king said, "Divide the living child in two, and give half to one, and half to the other."
Sorry. Now you see that. That's a bitter pill to swallow. Somebody got to swallow. And the thing about it is, that woman kept being persistent. She said, "No, that's my baby." She said, "That's my baby." She said, "Her baby dead, but that's my baby." So that shows you that woman got some wisdom too, though. That woman, she got some wisdom, and she got some mother. What they say about a woman intuition? Brother, we can't get around it, bro.
Yeah.
We can't get around it. Sometimes we got to. That's another thing we got to do, brother. Yeah. I'm parking right here. I'm going to park right here for a minute. That's another thing that I got to do. Because I ain't going to turn to look over that side over there. Sometimes you just have to listen.
Yeah.
I'm learning. Sometimes you just have to listen.
Regularly.
When they write, they write.
Yeah.
And they know.
And they don't need to be all here. When they write, they write.
Mm-hmm.
And you might as well just go and bow down and be humble. I just don't know. I learned from Brother Gilbert. I like to hang with Brother Gilbert. Brother Gilbert, I learned his word. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. like to keep peace in my house. I don't want to come home to a house. I don't want to come to my castle. I don't know how you do your house. I don't want to come home to my castle and got confusion all up in there. That's why you got to have wisdom to be able to watch. You gotta be able to wisdom. You gotta watch people that come to your house. Because sometimes they bring problems in your house to speak up to your wife, whispering to her ears. You got to be able to watch. And you got to be a prayer. You got to be a praying person. You got to be a praying person in Christ. Because when you watch, Jesus said it in the God of Gethsemane in Matthew chapter 26. He said, watch and pray that you enter not into temptation. For truly the spirit is with it, but the flesh is weak. When you watch, you can see the effects of Satan working.
And then you can begin
to pray. Do we forget what Paul said over in Ephesians chapter 6? Find in my brother, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. He tells us to put on the whole armor of God. But he also tells us when he get down there, he said, watch.
Yeah.
Watch and pray.
Yeah.
So when you got to watch that thing, when people come into your house and then, now sometimes it's your wife cut butter you hanging with them. Sometimes they in the church. You have to tell the truth about yourself. Sometimes they in the church. Listen, you have to watch how you live. People give you information in your marriage. And when people come to me and talk, I'm not the brightest person. But I got enough sense to tell me when people call me in the church, brother said, I said, brother, I don't know why you called me. Sister, I don't know why you called me. Really, I ain't gonna say that, sister. I let sister have a sister, I have brothers. The first thing you need to do, you need to take it to God and pray. Because Brother Campbell ain't got an answer for none of it. Take it to God and pray. And let God deal with you. Now, I can pray, we can encourage you, but I don't have the answer for it. I don't care if I've been through it, Brother Coffin. I let him take it to God first. If you ain't took it to God first, you came to the wrong person. I ain't got no answer for it. Go ahead, Brother Scott. I got way off course here.
And the king said, divide the living child in two, and give half to one and half to the other. Then spake the woman whose the living child was unto the king, for her bowels yearned upon her son. And she said, O my lord, give her the living child, and in no wise slay it. But the other said, let it be neither mine nor thine, but divide it. Then the king answered and said, give her the living child, and in no wise slay it. She is the mother thereof. And all Israel heard of the judgment which the king had judged, and they feared the king, for they saw that the wisdom of God was in him to do judgment.
Well, you see that? But before Solomon prayed that prayer, he probably couldn't have did that.
That's right.
He probably couldn't have did that. But he understood through that wisdom. He felt that woman hurt. Any woman that would just, she won't want to see her baby dead. No baby dead.
That's right.
But I'm not going to let mine die.
That's right.
I'm going to back up and let you have him. That he can be. As long as I can look at him, I'm all right.
Yeah.
And Solomon recognized that. Solomon said, no, no, no. That's the mother of that baby. That's the mother of that baby. That's the thing we need as Christians to be able to see that even in our brothers and sisters. When brother thought is going through something, he's not in the same bubble as yourself. Something is wrong. Something is wrong. And we don't need to be passed by that brother. Don't get that brother and tell the brother, I know something wrong, brother. I don't know what it is. I don't need no this, but I'm praying for you.
Amen.
I'm encouraging you.
Amen.
We need that brother and sister. Come on, we need to be true with this thing, man. We need to be true with this thing. We need it more than we ever needed before in this time. Because we're not going to get it nowhere else. We ain't going to get it out there in the streets.
No, we're not.
You're going to get cussed out and run off by the boat.
Yeah.
You ain't going to get it on your job. But as brother and sister Christ, brother called a preacher from the pulpit all the time, we are bound by the blood of Jesus Christ. And my Bible said, when Paul said over there in Corinthians, Paul said, we are members of one of another. It said, as Christ answered the church according to his purpose, his will. Not yours. We are all here on the purpose, divine purpose of God. We don't have a choice of denying a brother and sister in Christ.
Amen. You're right.
We go through it, we fight, we bite, but we need to come together. Need to be one in Christ.
Yeah.
And we need wisdom to do that.
Yes.
Wisdom, the wisdom of God will make you back up and say, hey, brother, I'm going to let you cool down.
That's right.
I'm not going to argue with you. I'm going to let you cool down. We're going to talk about this again.
In the cool of the day.
Cool of the day.
Yes, sir.
You said it right, brother. In the cool of the day. Mm-hmm. Because we keep adding law to the fire.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have a blaze, that's right.
We're going to have a blaze. Mm-hmm. But if we back off, because the Bible says a soft answer.
Yeah.
Turn away.
Come on,
man. But that's coming out of Solomon right now. Solomon, I think Solomon wrote that. And Solomon also wrote it in Proverbs chapter 4 and verse 23. He said, keep thy heart with all diligence.
Yeah.
For out of it are the issues of life. And I think Jesus said, that's why I don't want to quote all that. Go to Mark chapter. I think I got that written down on my paper. Go to Mark chapter 7, I believe it is. And Jesus tells us about what defiles a man.
Yeah.
It's in Mark chapter 7.
It's Mark chapter 7, starting at verse 14.
You see?
Yes, sir.
Go ahead and read it, bro.
Things from within defile a man. And when he had called all the people unto him, he said unto them, hearken unto me, every one of you, and understand. There's nothing from without a man that entering into him can defile him. But the things which come out of him, those are they that defile the man. If any man have ears to hear, let him hear. And he was entered, and when he was entered into the house from the people, his disciples asked him concerning the parable. And he said unto them, are you so without understanding? Also, do you not perceive that whatsoever things from without enter into a man, it cannot defile him? Because it entered not into his heart, but into the belly, and goeth out into the drunk, purging all meats. And he said, that which cometh out of the man, that defileth him.
Yes, sir. Yes.
From within, out of the heart of men, proceed evil thoughts, adulteries, fornications, murders, thefts, covetousness, wickedness, deceit, lasciviousness, an evil eye, blasphemy, pride, foolishness. All these evil things come from within and defile the man.
Remember in Jeremiah chapter 17, I believe it is. Remember when God said, the heart is deceitfully wicked?
Yes.
He said, who can know it? I can. Thanks be to God, he sent Jesus Christ. And when we got baptized in that water, we got the mind of Christ.
Amen.
We got some shields and some guard that can help us against the thought, because that old man would tend to rise sometimes. Mm-hmm. Let's be real.
Yeah.
Let's be real. Yeah. Let's be real. Sometimes we back a lot of us in the corner like a cat. That cat gonna come out that corner, man.
Yes.
Back a cat in the corner, see when he come out that corner. We'll be like Peter, we'll get that switchblade out and we'll go to. We got to be real. We got to be real. Like Brother Cox, we real people in a real world facing real problems. But we always got one advantage over you, over the world. We can repent of God of songs. And David shows us in that 51st, Solomon Daniel shows us in that 51st Psalm. He said, Lord, create in me a new heart and renew a right spirit in me. And then he go down further. He said, the sacrifice of God is a broken spirit and a contrite heart. God will not despise. He will not despise. And when we go back up, I seen that word where Jesus told the disciples, said, you don't understand. The disciples had to understand. We have to understand that it's not, the ball is really not in our corner. It's in our corner, but we need to learn how to serve others.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
We need to learn how to serve others. Mm-hmm. Not just in the church, but out in the church. But Paul said in Galatians chapter 6 and verse 10, as we have opportunity, do good unto all men, especially those of the household. But he put that perimeter of the household of faith. Always have charity. Always have good love for your brothers and sisters in Christ.
Yeah. Amen.
Let's go to James chapter 1. Let's see how this goes. James chapter 1. If we need wisdom, our Lord and Savior, God the Father, will not uphold it from us. He will give it to us. James chapter 1. Let's start at verse 4. Let's start. And read to verse 8.
But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. And if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that give it to all men liberally, and unbraideth not, and it shall be given him. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering, for he that wavereth like a wave of the sea driven with the wind and tossed. For let not that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Let the brother of low degree rejoice in that he is exalted, but the rich in that he is made low, because as the flower of grass he shall press away. For the sun is no sooner risen with a burning heat, but it withereth the grass, and the flower thereof falleth, and the grace of fashion as of it perish. So also shall the rich man fade away in his ways.
Start it up. In that patience having the perfect core. But when we get into the situation, and I'm gonna speak for myself, that's when the situation get uncomfortable, brother Dawg.
Yes, sir.
It get uncomfortable, and you want to run. Mm-hmm. You want to run. But you got to let God do his work through your life. Mm-hmm. You can't run.
Nope.
You got to learn to be consistent.
Dang.
Faithful.
Yeah.
Consistent.
Yeah.
Faithful.
Yeah.
Press. Strive. Press on and keep going on and let God do his perfect work.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because if God don't do the work in you, it will never get done. It never get done. The patience won't come. You won't have tolerance for people. Mm-hmm. You won't have love for people that you need to have.
Yeah.
You won't be able to put up with things that you need to put up
with. Yeah.
You're not putting them up for yourself.
Come on.
Because when you get the glory, you're gonna be able to sit down and tell you that Jesus is gonna serve us. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. See, he read that scripture. He was in the scripture this morning when he said we were unprofitable servants. I used to read that thing. I said, why would he say they're unprofitable servants? Because Jesus told him in another part, he said, glory in this, that your names are written in heaven.
Written in heaven.
Don't worry about this, what you're going through now, but that your names are written in heaven. And when our names are written in heaven, all this we go through on this earth won't matter to anything. But we just feel it because we in the flesh. Mm-hmm. We feel it because we impatient. Mm-hmm. We feel it because we selfish. Mm-hmm. We feel it. We just like Israel. Man. We should still take people.
Yeah.
We should still take people. Sometimes we want to have it our way, but you know what? I'm learning that when you don't feel like doing it, that's the best time to do it.
Yes.
That's right.
That's the best time to do it. Put yourself to it and go on and do it when you don't feel like doing it. Brother Thornton, if you don't get number one person in the clan, go do the clan.
Of course, yeah. Of course.
If you don't get up with it, go do the class anyway. If you do it by yourself,
yeah.
You show up. Because God looks high and he looks low. But the important thing is, in our lives, is how we stand in the position with God. When he looks down to see us, because the Bible says, when a man ways please God, he'll make even his enemy to be at peace with him.
Yes, sir.
It's what in his eyesight that matters.
Yes, yes sir.
And what we do in his eyesight, he knows everything.
Oh yes.
He knows everything. And that's and as Solomon was praying that prayer, and God added the material things to him. When we get the spiritual things, but Jesus said in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 33, seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and his righteousness, and all the other things will be added unto you.
Amen.
And when Solomon prayed that prayer, and we go back to the text and look at that, God, you look at this, God was so excited about that thing.
Yes, he was.
That he said, this only man's. Get back our text. Go back our text. Go back our text. I'm going to talk about it. Go back our text. Let's read it. 1 Kings chapter 3. If I can find one Bible. 1 Kings chapter 3. I think it's down here, Brother Starks. Okay, start up at verse 11, starts to come down. Verse 11, 1 Kings chapter 3, verse 11. Come
and
on
God
down.
God said unto him, because thou hast asked this thing, and hast not asked for thyself long life, neither hast asked riches for thyself, nor hast asked the life of thine enemies, but thou hast asked for thyself understanding to discern judgment. Behold, I have done according to thy words. Lo, I have given thee a wise and understanding heart. so that there was none like thee before thee, neither after thee shall any arise like unto thee. And I have also given thee that which thou hast not asked, both riches and honor, so that there shall not be any among the kings like unto thee all thy days.
Be 14:2.
And if thou wilt walk in my ways, to keep my statutes and my commandments, as thy father David did walk, then will I lengthen thy days.
That's the key. God was so amazed that Solomon asked for something. He didn't ask for a life of his enemy. He didn't ask for long life. He didn't give me a listening heart, an understanding heart,
yes,
that I can discern between your people. That I can take care of matters. That I can take care of issues. I know Solomon had to deal with his own self too.
Yeah.
That wasn't to deal with myself, because that's a heavy burden on a man of God to take care of the care of the church.
Oh, yeah. Amen.
Amen.
That's a heavy burden on it. Sometimes I look at him like, Lord, I don't want that job. I don't mind those first call that. That's a job, bro.
Yes,
that man go through some, he might not say nothing, that man go through some stuff.
Yeah.
And we need to pray for him.
Yes.
You need to keep him before the throne of God and his wife too.
Yes.
Family. Because we, like the old song said, no one knows what goes on behind closed doors. I ain't talking about no arguments.
Right.
I ain't talking about no arguments.
Yeah.
And we need to get, and that's, I'll be so glad to see that when we get on the road, I know it's take time and patience, but we get on the road and we can fulfill the needs that we need, elders, we can fill the church. That are his responsibility, that cares to take care of. Because the church was designed to be like that. That's what Christ said. That blueprint in the book of Acts, I know the church was in an infinite state. That blueprint was there for a reason.
Oh, yes, sir.
Because when people walked by and seen that, and on that day of Pentecost, people wanted to be a part of that.
Mm-hmm.
They wanted to be a part of it. They seen the love. They seen the joy. They seen the excitement they had for being a child of God. And they want to be a part of that. When you people come in and they see that, they see the love, they see that environment, they see that togetherness, people like, man, I want to be a part of that.
Amen.
I want to be a part of that. It's a pulling card. That's what God got for us, pulling. And what Jesus told them in John chapter 13, I believe it is, he said, men may know that you are my disciple by you loving one another. By you loving one another.
Amen.
And I'm going to close with here. I'm going to go some more with this. But I just want to say, Jesus Christ is the wisdom of God.
Mm-hmm.
He is the power of God.
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus Christ is the remedy for our sin.
Yeah. Yes.
And if we ought to be thankful that Jesus Christ thought about us, that God the Father thought about us,
yes,
and Jesus kept that God in the sin, when he got up and said, truly the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. But he went on to the cross with us on his mind.
Yeah.
Thank God for Abraham. Thank God for Isaac. Thank God for Jacob.
Yes,
thank God for all the men in the Old Testament
unto
the New Testament.
Amen.
Because God had us on his mind.
Yes.
He had the church. And the wisdom of God is what we need in our lives, more especially today.
Every day.
Every second, every minute, every hour of the day.
Yes.
Brothers and sisters, I don't know if I said anything to prick your hearts. I pray that I did through the Spirit of God.
Amen.
As God spoke to me tonight. But just keep, we need to keep the wisdom, the understanding, and the love of God. And realize that's what we need to grow by. And the key was in this verse when we got down here, to keep the statutes. God's word.
Yeah.
Jesus said, man don't live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Without food, we still can make it.
Amen.
Moses, it was proven through Moses
yes.
on the mountain when he went up on the chapter 40 days, and it was proven through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Yes.
But some of us ain't gonna make it on 40 days. Some of us ain't gonna make it 40 days.
40 hours.
They ain't gonna make it 40 days out of Shabbat. But Jesus Christ is the wisdom of God. And thanks be to God that he sent him to fulfill his purpose for us. He was nailed to the cross, and it wasn't the nails that kept him on the cross.
Oh, no, sir.
It wasn't the nails that kept him on the cross. It was love. Jesus said in John chapter 10, no man taking my life from me. I lay it down on myself. He said, I have this commandment of my Father, take the lie down and take it up again.
Yeah.
So that let us know that he died
Yeah.
To fulfill the will of the Father.
All right.
And we can't beat that.
Nope.
Can't nobody beat that. And one thing about the Church of Christ, we can back up with Scripture.
Right.
We can back up with Scripture.
Right.
That the Church of Christ is written in the pages of inspiration. Romans chapter 16 and verse 16.
Yep.
Paul says, salute one another with a holy kiss. The churches of Christ salute you.
Yes, sir.
We can show you from there. And Jesus said in Matthew chapter 16 and verse 18, he said, thou art Peter, and upon this rock I shall build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And we know on the day of Pentecost that he built the church, because the Bible says the Spirit came like a rushing mighty wind. And they filled the house where they were sitting, where nobody knew but the apostles.
Yep.
And the church was established. Yes. And we know from Scripture that it is the Church of Christ.
Amen.
And we can sit out with a Bible study with anybody, and we can prove it from the pages of inspiration.
All right.
You come by hearing, mm-hmm. believing, confessing, and repentance and confession that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. And be buried with him in the water of grave or baptism
yes,
for the remission of sins.
Yeah.
And you will be added unto the church because we got hope. Acts chapter 2 and verse 47 says, praising God, having favor with the people, the Lord added to the church. The Lord added to the church. The Lord added to the church because he built the church. David, that should be saved. And for us as Christians, let us diligently take an examination of our own selves.
Mm-hmm.
I got to do a better job of our own self. Let's take a daily examination of ourselves.
Yeah.
Stop looking at other brothers and sisters.
That's right. Yeah.
Because like I told your brother Campbell, you're going to find mistakes.
Yeah.
That's why they put erasers on pencil. We're going to make mistakes. Everyone's going to make mistakes. But we should be forbearing with another. That's where wisdom comes in. That's the true, godly, divine wisdom come in.
Yeah, yeah.
When you then you can tell something about yourself, that the Spirit is working in your life. When somebody do something to you, and you still say, man, forget that.
Yeah.
I'm still love that brother.
That's right.
I'm still love that sister. They might think I'm mad at them, but when they say something happened, what's called, I'm going to be right there beside them. Hey, brother, I got you.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. I thought that brother was mad. No, that was you thinking.
That's
what you think. I ain't gonna do my soul down worrying about this. No little something that happened ain't worth a hell of beans. That's how most folks say it ain't worth a hell of beans.
Yeah.
And we mad at one another over something that don't mean nothing. Because the number one thing you say you want to do, he want to get in the rooms. He want to get it anyway. If you give him an inch, he gonna take a mile.
Oh yeah.
If you give him an inch, he's going to take a mile. That's why we need to pray for one another daily on the diligence. We need to pray. We need to seek the wisdom of God more in our lives. Seek understanding and let God do the work in our lives.